G'day, it's Bill here from OpticsCentral. Today we're unboxing a Celestron CPC925, which is a big scope. Now, Celestron CPC925 is a Schmidt-Cassegrain, which means naturally that it has some severe focal length. It's a magnifying machine. The Celestron has the standard Celestron Star XLT coatings on it, which means that you get a good bright view through the lenses, and there's lots of nice transmission, that's good. Now, a scope like this is particularly good for planets. That's what it's really good at. It's also good for lunar shots, but only if you want individual craters, not the whole of the moon. The magnification is a bit much for the whole of the moon. It's good for bright, small nebulas as well, but only the brightest ones. And obviously star clusters as well, but again, small ones. The magnification means that you can't get the whole of the field into the telescope, therefore it's not going to look any good if you try to get a large one. It's got a dual fork Altazimuth mount. Dual fork means that it's good and stable, it's robust, it's not going to move around a lot. As you can see, it's very heavy. Looking down on the Celestron range, we've got the Evolution 925. Now, the Evolution 925 is a single fork mount, which makes it less stable. It has a slightly larger than normal for the Evolution tripod, but it's still not quite. The Evolution range has the built-in Wi-Fi and the built-in battery, which this guy doesn't have, so you have to buy them separately. In terms of size, lower in the Celestron range there's the CPC 800, which is exactly the same guy as this, only a fraction smaller. It's the same f-ratio, which means that the focal length is a little bit less, which means that the focal ratio is the same. Also up in the range is the CPC 1100. That's like the CPC 800, only the other side. It's a very, very similar setup. Same focal ratio, slightly longer focal length. Everything else is very similar. So let's get into the unboxing part. Instructions. Here we have the tripod. It's a little bit dusty out of the box. As you can see, there's a few bits of polystyrene on it, but it's quite functional. I'll just put that to one side and we'll get into the other one. Okay, here we have the OTA box. I suspect that this is going to take a lot of editing, but we'll get into this and see what we find. Okay, after much pulling and pushing, we've got towards the inner box. So inside we find a whole pile of information. Important note, don't look at the sun. And okay, here we have the accessories. First thing we have is a Celestron Nexstar hand controller, which is this is the way you communicate with the telescope. I won't throw this away. We have a visual back. That's an eyepiece. It's a 40mm eyepiece. There's a star diagonal, 1.25 inch, and quite a large 9x50 Celestron finder scope. There's a holder for the hand box that enables you to hang it on the edge of the tripod. is the electricity. And this is the bracket that enables the kinescope to go onto the actual tube. So there we go. And here we have the main part of the show. And it's enormous. I'm going to cut while I get myself some space for this. Okay, and we're back. And okay, I've got rid of the boxes. The first thing you can tell from this is no small telescope. It's big and it's heavy. Right, what we have to do is get it onto this mount. There's a little nut there that goes that locks up with a hole at the bottom of the scope. Then we rotate it until we hear some clicks, because there's three little recesses here. So let's just do that right now. There we go, do you hear that click? There we have it. Now, let's undo, drop these knobs. Don't do them up too tight. Just make sure that they bite, and then you come back later and tighten them up properly. Okay, there we go. Just give it a bit of a jiggle. Tighten them. Bit of a jiggle again. Just take out that slack they might have had. Okay, we're good. Behold the Celestron CPC925. Okay, we're back. We've got this all set up on its tripod, and let's go through the bits and pieces. First of all, I'll talk about the ports that you've got here on the tripod. We've got a hand control, and the hand control I'll attach that in a minute. But this is the way it goes in. You've got two auxiliary ports. There's a very handy Wi-Fi adapter or dongle that you can put into here. It enables you to use your phone or a tablet to control the mount, which means you don't have to touch it while it's moving, which can be very useful for a focal length as big as this. There's a PC port. You can attach your PC to this and use the next remote software to, again, control the mount. And there's an auto guide port. Now, the auto guide is for astrophotographers who want to take very long exposures. Typically, one of these GoTo mounts will track the stars beautifully, but if you want perfection, you need an auto guider, which is a second camera, a second telescope, a little camera, and it just goes and plugs in there. Clearly, the on-off switch and the power cord goes there. We've got, you may not be able to see it, we've got a power tank sitting on the ground. This you can take this to your car. It's got a cigarette lighter attachment. Or if you've got a power tank like we have, you can use that. Or you can get a wall adapter, an actual power plug that will go to this type of socket. All right, now moving to the bits and pieces that go onto the tube. We have, let's see, first of all, there's a little cradle here which fits just nicely in there. Nice little click. And that is the holder for the handbox, the hand controller goes in there, and oops, I'll just untangle from the microphone. And that goes into there, and that just sits quite conveniently there. The next thing is this is the mounting bracket for the finescope. The finescope has its own adjustment bracket which clips on there, and this is the finescope itself. It's quite a large finescope. It's a 9x50 from memory. If you bear with me for a second, I'll just attach this now. I'll probably speed this up in the video because it's going to be boring. Screwdriver. is, this is the bracket that goes for the finescope. I'll show you how you put this together. The finescope is this guy here. Quickly get this out. Okay. Now, there's a black ring. Now, the black ring sits in the front of the little jigger here, and that will go onto it. But it's actually easier to put a little black ring down the front. It takes a couple of goes, I've found. But if you put the rubber ring up around about there, possibly a little bit further forward, then this goes in the front there. Now, I don't know if you can see this. Withdraw these two adjustment rings screws as far as you can. This one is on a spring. It's a little bit hard to. It's quite an aggressive spring, that. So if you withdraw these two, you'll get enough room to get the finescope down there. It goes from the front, you feed it through to the back, and eventually the little black ring will just go in to there. You just push a little bit further, and with any luck, with a bit of jiggling, you'll be able to get it far enough in so that then you get these rings lined up with there's a little groove in there, and there you go. I'll show you how to adjust it in a second. Now, it goes up onto the CPC like that and screws it down with these bolts nice and square. Okay, I'll get back to that maybe later. The power cable is here. It's quite a lot of cable to it, but we're using a cable we've got in the shop here, so I'll leave that alone. I don't think I need to explain power cables too much. Now, I'll need a knife. The visual back. Let's see if I can organise this without cutting myself. The visual back is the mount for a lot of your optical stuff that just goes on the end here. The visual back just pops on here. We'll just take the little cover off it. Okay. Now the visual back just goes right on the end of the. I don't know why they call it a visual back. I suppose it's the back of the visual stuff. Thread. There we go. Now, on top of the visual back, or next along the train, is the star diagonal, 1.25 inch. This is a 1.25 inch visual back. And drop it. Looking good. Train, we have an eyepiece. This is a nice eyepiece. So that's going to provide a 40mm eyepiece, which is quite nice. Again, just roll that little cup up there. There we have, it's a 40mm plusel. I'm going to have to draw these things again. That should go into there. Now I'm indoors at the moment, so I won't be able to see anything. However, I'll just pop the end off and see if I can see light through it. Yes, we're unobstructed. Okay. I think that is all of putting the thing together. I'll get back to you in a moment with some more stuff about how you control it.